This is what I need to know about. Lily's last entry. Who's Mr. Smith? Where's room 207? I have to know.
These lips. Sheriff Wolf, would you like to make an appointment with me?
Then can you tell me? What are you suggesting?
What exactly are you suggesting?
We could make all the usual arrangements. The usual place.
She's telling... Oh.
I see. What would I need to do?
She's telling me without actually telling me.
I need 150. It's not good to be short.
I only have 58. Pay her? I don't have it all.
Wait here for a second.
Maybe I have more money now than I did last episode? Information book? Is that what that says? Got a new entry. So, wait. The Little Mermaid, but her name's Nerissa. Or is that her name now? Okay, we got a bunch of entries. I'm missing one. One entry. Georgie Porgy, the pimp. It was a Georgie Porgy pudding pie, kissed the girls. Oh, that's what was printed on... Tattooed on his chest. It says, kiss the girls. Kissed the girl and made them cry, so now he's a pimp. Georgie runs the Puddin' and Pie, a strip club that also caters to the unmentionable desires of Fabletown citizens. He has tried to... Clever Hans? He has tried just about everything there is to try in pursuit of worldly pleasures, but none of it satisfies him for long. He does seem to enjoy pushing people's buttons. He takes pride in his nightclub and doesn't react well to anyone meddling in his affairs. Really? This whole thing of the worldly pleasures but nothing satisfies him for long reminds me of Uncle Frank from Hellraiser. Clever Hans, bouncer, janitor, handyman. Clever Hans always does exactly as he's told. However, he often misunderstands his instructions and ends up hurting himself or behaving badly, really. As in the case of his noted fable where he threw sheep's eyes at his wife. Okay, I'm not familiar with that one. Unsurprisingly, she left him, and now Hans works at a bouncer in Georgie's club. He hopes to dance on stage one day, but for now he's content sweeping up and making sure the crowd doesn't get out of hand. Nerissa, the Little Mermaid. Nerissa's story never had a happy ending. She's known as the Little Mermaid, the young girl who gave up her tail for a pair of legs in the hopes of winning the heart of a handsome prince. When he married a princess, instead, Nerissa was left heartbroken. She made the journey to the mundane world, hoping for a better life. Now she dances at the Pudding and Pie, but each step she takes feels like walking on shards of glass. She has very little left, but finds some comfort in the company of her fellow dancers. Really? So is there a fable of the Little Mermaid from before the Disney movie with Ariel? I'm going to have to look that up. And we saw a lot more of The Little Mermaid than in any of these movies. There was only one movie, right?
207?
You'll think of something.
I will.
The Open Arms. This is where they met.
Enjoy your stay. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Thank you. She gave me $1 back. Okie dokie. Well, that's the Open Arms Motel there.
Hmm.
The Open Arms Hotel, the Bronx, late evening. Gola. No refunds. No public restroom. Smile, you're on camera. Not candid camera? Let's look at the sign here.
If the rooms are anything like the lobby, they should cut their rates.
Yeah, really. There's a payphone here.
They should probably repair that.
Looks pretty inoperable. Now, before I ding the bell for attention, let's look around some more. Oh, wait. Soda machine.
Yeah, this shit'll kill you.
As he takes a smoke. And that won't kill you, right?
Keep your pants on, buddy. You have to check in first if you want a room. So come on, mosey on back and we'll get you set up.
You hiding something?
Why can't I go upstairs? What's going on up there?
Oh.
Beauty!
Beauty.
I work here, okay? I work the front desk.
Obviously.
It's to help pay rent. So, now you know. I know I should have told somebody, but Beast would lose his mind if you knew. Beast is a proud man, Bigby. He wants to do right by me, and he just couldn't handle it if he knew I had to do this so we don't get evicted.
Well, you work
All
here.
All of our friends live at the Woodlands.
You should tell him.
Mortified.
You should really tell Beast. He's worried about you.
It's hard to keep that a
secret. I will. I just need to in my own time. By the way, thanks for covering for me. So, what are you doing here? Oh, you have a key.
Someone else was murdered last night.
I heard.
The victim was someone who worked at the Pudding and Pie. Lily. She, come around here ever?
Oh, yes. The troll. I did see her. I mean, you know, we never really spoke, but she came off a tad intimidating.
Understanding. So yeah, it's kind of hard to, like, work a job, even part-time, and keep it from someone you live with. And that's not gonna work out. Have you seen snow here?
Have you seen Snow White down here? Or maybe somebody glamored as her?
You know, it's funny. I did see someone who I thought looked a lot like her, but she didn't say anything when she saw me, even though she knew that I saw her. Hmm. I just assumed it wasn't snow and went about my business.
But same voice, right? Ever see Lily with anyone?
Ever see Lily with someone here? Maybe on a job.
Sometimes, but nobody I've recognized. I haven't worked here that long, though.
How about a room register? Or someone named Mr. Smith?
That's all we get here. Smiths, Jones, or Johnsons. I think the last ones are jokes.
Probably. He's not going to use a real name. Did you know Faith?
Ever meet a girl named Faith? Or just maybe hear that name?
I might have. I don't know. By the end of the night, it's kind of a blur with all the names. Tara, Brandy, Amber, Heather... Sorry.
Do you know Tweedledee?
I talked to Tweedledee earlier today. He mentioned you in passing. Do you know him, or his brother?
I took out a loan. For back pay. It was like our third notice. And ever since then, those annoying freaks have been pestering me for the money, plus interest.
Why take out a loan from those two?
It was from the crooked man.
Beauty.
Crooked.
You don't know how desperate I was, Bigby. I had nowhere else to go.
Look, if this ever happens again, come see me or Snow first, all right?
I tried.
Thanks.
Wait. It'll be better if anyone sees you, that they at least see you with me, so they know that I didn't let you just wander around by yourself.
Okay.
5 minutes, please.
We'll see, beauty.
Just be ready to act like I'm trying to kick you out.
That won't be hard.
Listen, Bigby. I assume you'll be filing some kind of an official report or something. Which is fine, it's just that I was wondering if I need to be in it. Do you have to mention my name? I mean, it's not like Beast would ever see your report. It's just...
You want me to lie?
You never know.
You're asking me to lie.
Not lie, just not include my name. Just say you talked to the clerk or something. You'll do what you have to. I just want you to know that that would help me. Well, here we are. Which one was it?
Oh my. Knock. Listen. Look at 203. So wait. How do I... It says 204. I'm gonna check all the rooms first. I'm so tempted, though. Open it?
You have keys to these rooms?
I thought you had a key.
Not to this one.
Hold on, Bigby. I can't just let you go into any room you want.
Why not?
I mean, what if someone's in there? You can't just go barging in.
Might be important.
I'm investigating a murder. I've got to check out all the angles. Never know what might be significant.
Well, I guess.
Really? I might have to blank this out too.
Hey, what the fuck?
Sorry.
Jesus Christ, you're gonna get me fired. I need this job.
Sorry.
Sorry about that.
Was again 204? This is 206. I hope I don't put myself in a fail state. I'm just really curious. Oh, 207! Oh, I meant to... Pound on it this time.
207. Open this one.
Well, that's weird. This key is supposed to open every room in the building, but it's not working.
Beauty!
Ah, shit.
Beast?
Bigby?
How do you find...
How could you do this to me?
No, sweetie, no.
Oh, we're not going in a room together.
How could you do this? We've been together through everything.
No, she works here.
I took care of you. I love.
It's not what you think. Please.
She works here.
You're cheating on me with him.
No.
Beast. I promise, I'm not. I'm helping him. That's all.
I'll bet.
Oh boy.
I'm sure you help each other just great. I know what this place is. I know what goes on here.
I'm on a case.
Not what I meant.
This is a murder investigation. She's helping me.
Stop lying to me.
What
the fuck is wrong with you? She's my wife!
Beast, listen to me! There's nothing going on! I'm not-
Oh boy.
Hey, bastard! I guess I finally see you for who you are!
Stop!
Not
Stop
really.
It!
You told me you hadn't seen her, you fucking liar!
Just
you
talk to your
sleeping
wife!
With her this whole time!
Listen to your wife. Just calm down and-
Beast!
Oh! I knew it.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
He's trying to punch me.
You aren't even listening to me!
She's my wife, Bigby!
I know!
I told you!
What? These two? Or either one.
Stop!
Oh, here we go again, grappling. wrestling.
Please! Leave him be! This is my fault!
You should be breaking stuff like God. That's gotta hurt.
Bigby, no! Don't hurt him!
He's had enough. Yeah, he's hasn't had enough. Ow. That's what you get for trying to be nice.
You ruined everything!
Please.
She's my fucking...
Now we get to see what's in room 207. Well, those flowers.
Shit, Bigby.
I never get to...
What have you done?
204.
What is this?
I'm surprised you can see.
Bigby.
Look what you did to the door! You can't just act like this whenever
Stand
you-
back! You don't want to see this.
Oh my. Door's open now.
Well, we got the door open.
Oh my god!
Don't touch anything.
Is this-
What's that book?
Lily met her client here, Mr. Smith. Whoever he is.
I thought it was 204.
Must have happened right here.
Jesus.
Well, last night?
Yeah?
I was on shift last night.
On shift? Beauty, what?
I'm not a prostitute, you idiot. I work the front desk.
So that's...
Yeah.
Still, this is no place for someone like you. I mean, look.
Can we please not talk about this?
Who rented this
Do
room?
Do you remember who rented this room last night?
I don't think anyone did. Not last night. Maybe they have it long term. I don't know. How am I supposed to know? It just seemed like a totally normal night. How is that even possible? There's so much blood.
To the
Go
big
lock
troll.
The front door. Keep people out of the hallway. I need you to be sure no one comes in here. This is a crime scene, okay?
But...
Just do what he says. I'll explain later, okay?
Go get yourself cleaned up.
Bigby, what kind of a person could do something like this?
That's exactly what I'm about to try to find out.
Evil one?
I can't believe this.
Looks like she was lying down when she was killed. Flowers were already here.
Like the one
How
in her hand.
How do you know that?
Blood pattern. Also, I'd say the body was dragged off the foot of the bed. There.
The body. Jesus, you could say she. Poor girl. I just can't even imagine.
Okay. Storybook. Yeah, I saw that. Grimm's Fairy Tales? Is that what it says? Oh, that's
What is that?
German.
It's a book about Snow White. Or about the Mundy version of her story, anyway.
Well, that's in German.
The whole book is about her?
Yeah.
Red Fuji? Red Delicious Empire? Someone was wondering what kind of apple she was holding. Beautiful. Was she breathing?
Why is she in a glass coffin?
This is the part where she's in a deep sleep, but they think she's dead.
What's it mean? Why mark the page where she's sleeping?
The bed matches the coffin.
I think he made up the bed to match the coffin in the picture. Flowers, too. He'd have had Lily lie down just like this.
Connected the
you
evidence.
Mean just before?
In the story, that's when someone comes to kiss her. That's our Mr. Smith.
This is creepy. The coffin and the weird fixation on snow. What the hell is wrong with this guy?
Well, Georgie Porgy kisses the girls. J. If I could read German. I cannot, unfortunately. Something gift? Yeah, I don't know. Ashtray.
God.
It's a huff and puff.
I thought you were the only one who smoked that crap brand.
Apparently not.
They also have them in, Pudding place.
He brought wine.
Classy. Poor girl.
For my arrival? Rogers. Saw the name F. Rogers.
Just unbelievable.
On the list? I don't know if that means anything. So yes, room 204 key, this is 207. Cassette. It was a closet. I didn't finish looking at the bed though, there was something else. Oh, the flowers, right? Oh, an apple? Oh. Oh, that's on the floor.
Do you smell something?
No. Just apple.
What are you thinking?
It's like the apple in the book.
It's got a single bite taken out of it, like in Snow's story.
Oh, no. Do you think it was poisoned?
It wasn't. I'd have smelled that. I think it's just a prop. It's here because they were acting out the scene in the book.
Right.
Of course. That makes perfect sense. It fits. He's acting out scenes from the book. That poor girl. She couldn't have known. She probably just needed the money. She could have been anyone.
Someone's hasn't gone away yet.
How did she wind up here? I mean, not exactly here, but just how does a person...
We can't know the answer to that. Every situation is different.
Yeah. She must have been so scared.
Probably. Oh, use cassette with cassette player.
Do all the rooms have these same clocks with a built-in cassette player?
I think so, yes. Maybe she didn't see it coming.
Hmm.
Damn it, get it together, Beauty. Be strong.
He just looks at it, okay. In goes the tape.
Bigby, this? I think I heard this music last night. It was playing pretty loudly for a while and then stopped in the middle. I didn't think twice about it at the time. I mean, you hear all kinds of things around here and I guess I've already gotten used to blocking them out.
Could have covered up the sound of the murder.
Hmm. Yeah, he just looks at it now.
God.
I was gonna compare the lilac with the other lilac. Oh, let's look in the closet then. It's the only thing left other than talking to her. Oh.
Someone's been rough with this dress. It's torn.
Oh no. She must have been wearing it. He killed her and then he took it back off?
No, there's no blood on it. It must have been torn some other time.
Hmm.
Oh no, there's more? What? What now?
Looks like a snow costume.
This is the same dress as the one in the book about snow. I think Smith was dressing Lily up in it to recreate the snow from the book.
Right.
You're right. It's the same dress. It's another match to what's in the book.
But not when the day she was killed.
I can see the whole picture now. It all goes together like you said. This creep put that girl in a snow-white dress and recreated the whole story from the book with the apple and the deep sleep and everything. You're a better detective than I thought you'd be.
Thanks.
So he planned it all out. He had all the details noted down. Only then, when it comes time to kiss her and wake her up...
Yeah.
Kills her.
I hope you're just about through. I don't really want to stay in here any longer.
I don't know if I am. What we got here? An envelope.
Are those pictures of the dead girl?
Or of Snow White herself.
All of them.
How do you know?
I'm in this one. It was taken last winter.
Huh.
Oh no. Bigby. This kind of stalking, it doesn't just stop by itself. Trust me, I know about this firsthand. He'll keep trying to get closer and closer.
His stand-in for Snow is gone now, so...
The next step closer.
It's the real thing.
It's Crane.
I knew it! Oh, he's watching in the mirror, too. I knew it was him. Oh! You broke the mirror! Damn, what did the mirror ever do to you? Showed you something you didn't want to see. Next time on The Wolf Among Us. It was a shorter episode.
He could be after you now.
Good. I am dying to get my hands on that disgusting weasel.
He's got the fetish, or whatever you want to call it. That makes glamours.
I'm really starting to like you, Sheriff. You're not afraid to be a complete bastard.
Yeah, why be afraid of that?
Obviously, there will have to be some changes.
Oh. He's gonna take over.
Hello, Bigby.
Oh, hello again.
Take care of it, Bigby, or I'll take care of it for you.
Hmm.
Jesus Christ, Bigby. Is that you?
That Mr. Toad? Okay, player choices. 61% of players sympathized with Crane about Snow's death. Well... That was before we found out the truth. How would you treat the murder suspect? 62.4% of players persuaded him to talk. Good job. Did you let Snow come with you to the trip trap? 92% of players let her make her own decision. How would you handle Georgie Porgy? 70% of players didn't hit Georgie. Did you keep punching Beast when he was down? 77.8% of players opted not to hit Beast a second time. So I'm in the majority with all this stuff. Cool. I didn't get all the... I didn't get all the entries again. I'm missing one. God damn. How do we find these missing entries? Don't answer that. By the time you watch this, I'll have been done with the entire thing. So damn, just another 3 or 4 episodes this time, a little shorter. Bluebeard, Dave Fenoy. So I am enjoying this muchly. I'm enjoying this just about as much as Walking Dead Season 1. That tells you anything. Because that was the best one. Season 2. Three. Last one was a little bit better, but still. This is up there with my favorites. Better than Guardians of the Galaxy. Better than the Batman games. I'm enjoying it a lot. Of course, it has to do with the setting and characters from Fables. But there are some really interesting segments looking at things, piecing together evidence and stuff like that. I think they had a lot of good material to work with on this. Why would they always name... They always thank their pets with the crazy names. I want to double check. Damn. Again, missing one. I hope at the end it unlocks them just so we can look and see who. It must be related to a certain choice we make. Like, say for example, we had gone to help Prince Lawrence to get him first. Maybe that would have unlocked this. I have no idea. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, episode 3, part 1. And always seek adventure.